Well, I was somewhat of a nerdy kid. My mother tells people that I first said that I wanted to be mayor when I was 8 years old. I happened to meet the former Republican mayor of Baltimore, Theodore McKeldin, on the street one day and had seen him on TV, and he stopped and shook my hand, and I was just impressed. And I told her that's what I want to do when I grow up. But what happened for me is that a lawyer in town, I was working with a law firm, and he asked me what I wanted to do with my law degree, and I told him I wanted to be mayor. He said, "I didn't ask you what you wanted to be, I asked you what you wanted to do." And that really hit me, and I said, "Wow, I've been so worried about and thinking about status. If somebody gave me the magic wand today and made me mayor, I'd wouldn't have an agenda." So I began thinking about that, what I wanted to do and what kind of impact. And so I had this law degree. I knew I was interested in public law, and I became state's attorney. And the thing that was so consistent is that I saw education as having a huge impact on the quality of life for people, and the lack of education is what I saw consistently dealing with young men coming through the criminal justice system. So I said, let's get on the side that deals with education and not just at the end when we're trying to prosecute. So I ran for mayor on the platform of making Baltimore known as the city that reads. And that was simply to say we must be committed to lifelong education to lift up our community, lift up the individuals in the community. I mean, I was served as mayor for 12 years. I thank the community for that. We had some successes, we had some failures. We had to deal, unfortunately, with the crack cocaine problem, which hit Baltimore late. And unfortunately, it really hit us in the late 80s, early 90s, around the time that I was becoming mayor. And it was also at a time that I was participating in a national debate and critique about the war on drugs. I mean, I saw, having been a prosecutor for 8 years, I recognized that the war on drugs was just misguided and it needed to be more of a public health war rather than criminal justice war. But I did, and a lot of people thought that I was, kind of soft on crime. I was not. I mean, we were still arresting and prosecuting a lot of people, but it was not moving in my view, in the right direction. And, as we see this explosion of the opioid problem nationwide, it's recognizing that this is a health problem. We got to deal with the addiction and the demand for this product, these products, and we've got to do it in a way that's more public health oriented rather than criminal justice oriented. We're attempting to do a lot of different things in addressing the homicide problem because we recognize that although we had this big spike in 1993, the community actually had almost become used to having more than 200 homicides. Because if you go all the way back, not just in the 90s, but all the way back to 1971, you see over 300 homicides in 1971. Well, that's before crack. That's, why? And so when I was state's attorney, from 1982, 1987, we had anywhere between 200 and 225 homicides a year, and nobody screamed crisis. We should have been talking about crisis, but 200 homicides a year, when other countries, that would have been outrageous. We had, in some way, just got used to a large number. But throughout the 1990s, that was one of the biggest problems of my tenure as mayor. 10 of the 12 years that I was mayor, we had over 300 homicides. And I believe most of that was because of crack cocaine coming in late, and we had unsettled distribution markets, gangs basically, crews warring over turf. So what I was trying to explain to people, though, is that this was a war over money. This was distribution rights. And that's the problem with the war on drugs, is that it drives the distribution of these substances underground, and you have all these guys warring over the profit. So we got to come up with ways to take the profit out of distributing drugs at the street level. And that's, I think, what later approaches are trying to do: more treatment, get try to drive the demand down. But we continue to see that problem in our community.